Let's talk about Matthew Tkachuk in this video. Is there a bunch of fluff, or is there actually some merit to it? Hi there, it's Brett Hornby here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. And definitely was stunned to see, apparently there's some rumors that, does Matthew Tkachuk want out of Calgary? That's the question, and definitely raises some eyebrows on potentially if that's the chase. But I hope that's not the truth, as talk about in this video that apparently it's Shane O'Brien, and former player who actually used to play for the Calgary Flames, dropped this rumor that talks about that apparently Matthew Tkachuk wants out of Calgary, which is definitely a little concerning. Considering I still feel that the Calgary Flames need to make a change in the core, but I would think Matthew Tkachuk is one of those untouchable young players that we try to build around, and I could see maybe potentially Matthew Tkachuk being the next captain of the Calgary Flames. But this is touching upon that Shane O'Brien now with Sportsnet dropped a little bombshell with Steve Kulius that the hockey world has been buzzing. That according to Shane O'Brien, he apparently has, you know, many connections with any insiders, and I haven't seen much on this, you know, on the main sites like Sportsnet or TSN with their insiders, or even Hockey Buzz. Hockey Buzz hasn't even, you know, talked about this potential rumors. Matthew Tkachuk wants to get out of Calgary, and the rumors is that he does want to play for the St. Louis Blues. I mean, you can understand that. I mean, that's where he was born. His dad, Keith Tkachuk, he was born when Keith Tkachuk was playing in the St. Louis Blues, but I just don't think right now, don't think Matthew Tkachuk really saying he wants to leave Calgary. There hasn't been any word. I mean, obviously the Calgary Flames aren't going to say yes. He's Matthew Tkachuk, he said he wants to get out of here because that's not killing any leverage. But even then, if we were to trade Matthew Tkachuk just to shake things up, or if he does want out of Calgary, I wouldn't necessarily say St. Louis would be the place to trade into right now. I mean, apparently, it was a frustrating season for Matthew Tkachuk and any other Flames. He hasn't looked like the same player. And I know that it seemed like there was word that the team told him to tone it down a little for being the pest. And now there was that boiling pot moment where Jake Muzzin flipped pucks on him and he really went off early in the season. And apparently after that, some of the team told him to tone it down. And the fact that it seems like that kind of took away from his game, but makes him more effective, is he is that, you know, power forward that can be pest to the opponents, and definitely is an asset that we need to have. But that's going back to that, but I still think that Matthew Tkachuk is still primed to rebound. I mean, two words, contract year, because after this season, 21-22, he is going to be a restricted free agent. And he's going to make at least $9 million, and he's only 23 years old, so he's still a young player. And it was under unusual circumstances, but apparently, if he does want out, he wants to go to St. Louis. I mean, that's where he's from. That's where his dad played. And I know that Keith Tkachuk actually still lives in the St. Louis area. But the only possible package that we can get for Matthew Tkachuk, realistically, from the St. Louis Blues, that I don't think would be as intriguing, is that we would potentially get forward Vladimir Tarasenko from the St. Louis Blues. And yes, he is one of the best snipers in the league, but he has had some injury problems the last couple of years. That, and he's 6 years older than Matthew Tkachuk. I wouldn't really necessarily be wise to want to trade Matthew Tkachuk for Vladimir Tarasenko. It also talks about that, he has makes about the same cap hit right now at $7.5 million for Vladimir Tarasenko. Matthew Tkachuk's cap hit is $7 million right now, but in actual money he gets $9 million, and the qualifying offer is that he's going to have to at least get $9 million for next season for his new contract. But it's just the fact that Vladimir Tarasenko is a little bit of damaged goods and still is working. I know he had a five straight seasons that he had at least 30 goals, including a 40-goal season, and he was a big part of St. Louis Blues run when they went to the conference championship in 2016, and winning the Stanley Cup in 2019. I know the other players that they would have to consider getting to make this trade kind of work is it touches upon that young players like Vince Dunn and Jordan Kuru, who are both restricted free agents coming into this offseason. But I still think that I think it's more fluff than actual, you know, rumors to this story. Merit to any of these rumors about Matthew Tkachuk wanting out of Calgary. I mean, unless we hear anything otherwise, I mean, the Calgary Flames aren't going to admit either way, because they didn't want to can only leverage with their one of their top bright players. And I think Matthew Tkachuk is one of the players that we should build around, especially with Elias Lindholm and Andrew Mangiapane, when his stock has risen, especially how he performed in the World Hockey Championships for Team Canada, winning the MVP, and Team Canada's fortunes turned around when Andrew Mangiapane was finally able to go over to Latvia to help Team Canada win the championship in the most unorthodox way possible. But I just think there is more fluff than merit to this rumor in my mind right now. I mean, I don't want to trade Matthew Tkachuk for anything. I know that I made a video talking about should the Calgary Flames potentially make a play for Jack Eichel. I mean, if there's a scenario that Matthew Tkachuk has to get traded, I would be more willing to part with him in a package to get Jack Eichel from Buffalo than Vladimir Tarasenko from St. Louis. I mean, no respect to Vladimir Tarasenko, but even then, both Vladimir Tarasenko and Jack Eichel have had to get some surgery to get some injuries repaired. I mean, Vladimir Tarasenko had issues with his first surgery that he had to get a second surgery, and then Jack Eichel, I understand, he's getting an experimental never-be-done surgery before, but Jack Eichel, I think, has more potential to be that franchise player, and yes, I think the Calgary Flames still need to consider making changes to the core. I still think Johnny Gaudreau and Sean Monahan are more likely to be moved. We can't just stand pat, because I think if we stand pat, we're going to be once again next season looking at either just missing the playoffs or just getting in and getting out of the first round, unless we make a change. But I just don't think right now there's very, very little chance, unless Matthew Tkachuk himself busts into Daryl and Siders and Brad Treliving's off and said, I want to get the, you know what, out of Calgary. I think right now this is just fluff, because I haven't seen anything else other than this Shane O'Brien, you know, rumor. I mean, I haven't seen it even on Hockey Buzz. And speaking of Hockey Buzz, actually Hockey Buzz even talked about that. Apparently there's word that, and he gives it an E4, that Calgary's actually been talking to Buffalo with a trade for Jack Eichel involving Johnny Gaudreau. So maybe there's some air to that, but there's been also rumors with Buffalo asking almost a ridiculously high price for Jack Eichel, especially if you look at some rumors that Columbus apparently might be almost priced out, and they have pieces that they can give to the Buffalo Sabres, including the high first-round pick, one of their goalies, and maybe Patrick Laine, but it's just all negotiating tactics right now. But I just say, what do you think of this rumor with Matthew Tkachuk? I just hope it's not true. I still think it's fluff right now. I would be extremely, extremely shocked, unless we get a, you know, franchise player return, that I think Matthew Tkachuk is still going to be a Calgary Flame next season and a few years beyond. I can maybe potentially see Matthew Tkachuk down the road maybe going to play for the St. Louis Blues, but not right now. And I just don't think right now the St. Louis Blues has a package that would appeal the Calgary Flames to part with him. And then going back to Vladimir Tarasenko, he does have a no-movement clause in his contract. Would he necessarily would want to waive it to come to Calgary? I still think with Jack Eichel, he wants to get out of Buffalo and be willing to go anywhere. And I would say, I think there's a better chance that Jack Eichel would want to go to Calgary than Vladimir Tarasenko at this stage. But I just think this rumor is just a little crazy, too outrageous to be true, if you ask me. But, I mean, obviously the Flames aren't going to say anything. But, of course, if they do anything major like this, I'll make a video on it. And that's what I mostly do on my channel. So, as I say, if you want to follow along this Calgary sports fan's journey, home of Flames 7, Roughnecks and Stampeders, I mostly do talk Calgary sports or recap games and stories. And I just touched on a couple of rumors that seemed sort of outrageous. I also talked about, you know, is Rick Tocchet potentially going to join the coaching staff with Calgary now that he did not get the head coaching job with the Seattle Kraken? But it seems like Calgary's already filled out their coaching staff for this upcoming season. And then this Matthew Tkachuk story just Shane O'Brien, who's on Sportsnet, that he used to play. He actually used to play for the Calgary Flames at one point in his career, but I just think Matthew Tkachuk at this stage is still an untouchable, unless he pounds his fist on the desk of Brad Treliving and Daryl Sutter and say, I need to get out. And he would think Daryl Sutter, once he gets more time to settle in his first full season as head coach under more normal circumstances, that I think we'll see more of the Matthew Tkachuk back next season. And the fact that he has that contract year coming up, then he wants to get qualified for that $9 million. But the other things I also touch upon, talk about my YouTube channel. I don't just do Calgary sports. I also do first vlogs, attempt to comedy, and also do Shermer's Criticism on the Road, I swear to it, and I've been doing some more vlogging on the go. So if that all sounds like be interesting to watch, to follow along with this Calgary sports fan's journey, you know what you do, just make sure you hit like and subscribe. I also have my other social links down in the description below. For other ways you can follow me, so I'll just have to ask what I said at the beginning. Is there actually some truth and merit to this rumor that Matthew Tkachuk wants to get out of Calgary and wants to play for the St. Louis Blues? Or is it just a bunch of fluff at this point? I think it's a bunch of fluff. I hope it's not true. I am not willing to part with Matthew Tkachuk as a Calgary Flames fan unless, I get something that I just can't refuse. And if I had to trade him away, I'd rather go back to the, with the Buffalo Sabres if it involves getting Jack Eichel as opposed to Vladimir Tarasenko. But, it is what it is. But I think this is just something that was just thrown out there that none of the bigger insiders are talking about. And once they start saying something, then I think there is more merit to it. So I just want to say, go Flames go, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.